ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय So as we approach the auspicious day of Janmashtami, we will try to speak something about the significance of the appearance of Lord Krishna in this world.
因为我们马上就要到了吉祥的Janmashtami，所以今天我们来讲一下主 Krishna 在这个世界上吉祥的显现。
First of all, there are some misunderstandings by ordinary people about the position of Lord Krishna.
首先就是普通人对于主 Krishna的地位有一些误会。
Some people, they are thinking that actually Vishnu is the Supreme Lord and Krishna is his incarnation.
有些人就认为，实际上Vishnu才是至尊主，而Krishna只是Vishnu的化身而已。
They think Vishnu's position is above Krishna. Because Vishnu has four arms, Krishna only has two, so they think Vishnu must be greater than Krishna.
他们认为Vishnu的地位高于Krishna，原因是Vishnu有四臂，而Krishna只有两臂，所以Vishnu的一定比Krishna伟大。Also,
many of the Puranas they speak about Vishnu, they don't speak about Krishna. Krishna's position is highlighted only in the Srimad Bhagavatam.
同样的，就在《普拉那邦诗书》当中，也就是主要提及的是Vishnu，而Krishna的地位呢，只是在圣典薄伽瓦坛当中才提到。So
there are some reasons why, we have to understand the different philosophical points in order to appreciate Krishna's supreme position as the personality of Godhead.
我们必须理解一些哲学要点，这样呢，才好利于我们理解 Krishna 作为至尊性格神首的至尊无上的地位。
One point is that Krishna is Ras Amrita Murti. He is the form of all different rasas.
首先, Krishna 是 Rasa Amrita Murti, 是不同 Rasa 形象的 Murti.
Yes, there are five primary rasas: Santa, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya, Madhurya. Or neutrality, servitude, friendship, parenthood, and conjugal love. And they are all seen in the presence of Lord Krishna.
有五种不同的Rasa，中性的、仆人的Rasa、朋友的Rasa、父母之情，还有情侣之爱，所有这些Rasa都可以在主Krishna身上看到。
However, Lord Vishnu is he's the Lord of Vaikuntha, and in Vaikuntha, the mood in Vaikuntha is Dasharat, servitude.
而Vishnu呢是Vaikuntha之主，在Vaikuntha上面的 Rasa呢是 Dasya Rasa.
We don't see that Lord Vishnu enjoys much intimate friendly dealings with his devotees, but he's always the Lord above them.
我们没有看到主Vishnu和他的奉献者之间的亲密交流。
Because the nature of Vaikuntha is opulence, and where there's opulence, there's more awe and reverence.
在Vaikuntha上的本质呢，是以富裕占主导，而在这样的情况当中 敬畏之情总是非常显著的。
And that mode of awe and reverence creates a distance between the Lord and His devotees.
这种敬畏之情就在主和他的奉献者之间呢，制造了一段距离。
But Lord Krishna, on the other hand, he enjoys more sweetness. And with the mood of sweetness is intimacy.
在另一方面，主 Krishna 呢，总是在享受着甜美之情。而这种甜美之情呢，就会营造一种亲密的氛围。
Yeah, Krishna enjoys being very close with his devotees and having very intimate association with them.
主 Krishna, 在和他的奉献者的关系当中呢，就是其乐融融，非常的享受这种关系。
Krishna enjoys performing wonderful pastimes with his devotees.
Krishna 特别喜欢和他的奉献者一起上演逍遥时光。
And Krishna enjoys even being controlled by the pure love of his devotees.
Krishna 也特别喜欢被他的奉献者的纯爱所控制。
In Srimad Bhagavatam, it is also stated in the first canto, the third chapter, there's a list of all the different incarnations of the Lord. And after describing all the incarnations, then Srila Vyasadeva describes that Lord Krishna is the original Supreme Personality of God.
圣典波迦瓦坛第一篇第三章列举了主的各个化身，其后是维阿萨德夫便描述到 Sri Krishna 是最原初的至尊性格神手。
There are many many incarnations, but Ete Chamsa Kalapumsa Krishna's to Bhagavan Swayam. It is Lord Krishna who is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead.
所以这句诗文的意思就是，主有众多的化身，然而其中主 Krishna 是至高的，是至尊的原始的性格神手。
So this is one point which we have to impress upon people, because there are other Vaishnavas, just like the other Vaishnavas, like the Sri Vaishnavas, Ramanuja Vaishnavas, they accept Vishnu as the Supreme rather than Lord Krishna.
我们必须要把这一点呢强调给别人，因为有还有其他的 Vaishnava 师徒传承，比如说 Sri Vaishnava 传承和 Ramanuja Acharya 的传承，他们都认为主 Vishnu 才是至尊主。比 Krishna 要高。
So this point was discussed in Chaitanya Charitamrita by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu when he went to South India to Sri Rangam.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 当他去南印度旅行的时候，他在 Sri Rangam 庙也。他在 Sri Rangam 庙也强调了这一点。
When he was in Sri Rangam, he was staying with some Sri Vaishnava family, and he would talk to them about the position of Lord Krishna and Lord Vishnu.
主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 在 Sri Rangam 的时候呢，他就驻留在一个 Sri Vaishnava 的家庭当中。在这个家庭当中，他就跟这家庭的成员讨论了 Sri Krishna 的地位。
And he explained to them how Lord Vishnu Lord Vishnu's consort is Lakshmi. And Lakshmi is a very chaste woman. But Lakshmi went to Vrindavan to try to get entrance into Krishna's Rasa Leela.
他解释说呢，主Vishnu的妻子伴侣是Lakshmi Devi，Lakshmi Devi是最贞洁的女士，但是Lakshmi Devi呢，竟然想去Vrindavan进入主Krishna的Rasa Leela。So
Lakshmi is very chaste woman. Why would she want to go and dance with another man? But of course, the Sri Vaishnavas said, "Oh no." Krishna and Vishnu are the same. There's no difference.
既然Lakshmi Devi是最贞洁的妇女，她为什么要去另外一个地方和另外一个男人跳舞呢？但是这个传承的解释就是说，不是不应该这样想。Sri Krishna 和 Vishnu 他是一个人。
So Lord Chaitanya said, then why did Lakshmi not get to go into the Rasa Leela? Everyone knows Lakshmi went to Vrindavan and she did austerities there for a long time.
众所周知, Lakshmi Devi 她去Vrindavan苦行了很长时间。
She wanted to take part in Krishna's Rasa Leela.
她渴望参与是 Krishna 的 Rasa.
But she never got in. She was not able to enter the Rasa Leela.
但是她没能进入 Rasa 之舞.
Lord Krishna told her, you want to come to Rasa Leela? You have to become a gopi. You cannot come as the goddess of fortune.
主Krishna告诉他，倘若你要进入Rasa之舞，你必须得成为一名gopi，牧牛姑娘，你不能以幸运女神的身份来进入Rasa之舞。
Of course, if somebody who is the goddess of fortune, it's not an easy thing for them to become a gopi, because the gopis are village girls.
当然了，一个幸运女神，她是无法就成为一名乡村的狗匹牧牛姑娘的。
The goddess of...
因为牧牛姑娘们，她们都是一些村姑而已。
But the goddess of fortune is used to enjoying opulence, and she's a queen, and she has many servants, and it's not, so for her to become like a village girl, a village woman, it's not possible.
幸运女神呢，习惯了有富裕的氛围，她习惯作为王后的身份。 下面有很多仆人、侍从在簇拥着他，而那个村姑对他来说呢，就当一名村姑简直是不可能的。The
goddess of fortune resides with the supreme lord and enjoys the opulence of Vaikuntha and enjoys living in palace and great opulence with all kinds of facility for enjoyment.
幸运女神，她是和至尊主一起居住在百昆塔的宫殿里，而他们有很多的设施，有很多的便利。But
to become a village cowherd girl means you have to take the cow dung and you have to make the patties and you have to live a very simple, austere life.
在另一方面，成为一名农村的乡下的牧牛姑娘，就意味着要搜集那些牛粪，把牛粪拍成牛粪饼，然后这种生活是非常苦行又很简单的生活。
So Lakshmi she was never able to take part in Rasa Leela, but the Lord blessed her that she would reside on the body of the Lord.
所以, Lakshmi 女神永远没能进入Rasa之舞当中，但是主祝福她能够居住在主的胸膛。
So in this way, we different arguments are given to help us understand the superior position of Lord Krishna over Lord Vishnu.
就这样，经典当中呢，给出了种种的论点来证明主 Krishna 地位是高于主 Vishnu 的地位的。
Another point to be understood about Lord Krishna is who is actually the mother and father of Krishna.
有另外一个关于主 Krishna 的论点，就是他的父亲和母亲到底是谁？
Now generally people think that Krishna is born in Mathura and he's the son of Vasudev and Devaki.
一般人们都认为主 Krishna 是诞生于 Mathura， 他的生身父母呢是 Vasudev 和 Devaki。
But if you ask the people of Vrindavan, who is Krishna's mother and father, the Vrindavan people will say Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda are the parents of Krishna.
但是如果你要是询问问Vrindavan的居民的话，他们就会斩钉截铁地告诉你，Krishna的父亲是Nanda Maharaj，他的母亲是Yashoda Devi.
So this has to be understood. Who is actually Krishna's mother and father?
所以呢，必须要理解Krishna的生身父母到底是谁。
So it is described, of course, in different scriptures. By first of all, we have in Srimad Bhagavatam, we have the birth of Lord Krishna.
那么在经典当中呢，首先。
Then there's a book by Jiva Goswami called the Gopal Champu, which also describes about Krishna's appearance.
另一方面，我们有Jiva Goswami的 Gopal Champu 也描述了主 Krishna 的降生.
And there's also a book called the Hari Vamsha, which also describes about Krishna's appearance.
另外一部经典 Hari Vamsa 同样描述了主 Krishna 的降生。
So Srimad Bhagavatam also of course describes about Lord Krishna, and we get the reason why Krishna comes. We have to understand what's Krishna's mission. Why should he come to this world?
在圣典博加瓦坛当中，就描述了主 Krishna 他降生的原因，他在这个世界上的使命。
Krishna has his eternal abode in the spiritual world. Why will he come to this material world?
主 Krishna 在灵性世界拥有自己永恒的居所，他为何又要来到这个物质世界？
In material world, this material world is not a very pleasant place. Why should he come here?
这个物质世界可不是什么让人愉快的地方。他为什么要来这个物质世界呢？
Well, we could say because he's a well-wishing friend. He's the best friend of all living entities. So he comes out of his kindness to deliver us.
我们可以说，因为他是众生的祝福者，是众生最好的朋友，所以他来此是为了拯救众生。
We have forgotten Krishna, but Krishna did not forget us. That's why he came here.
我们已经遗忘了 Krishna, 但是他并没有遗忘我们，所以他才来物质世界。
And he's of course he's in the heart of everyone. As a Paramatma, trying to help us, to guide us.
当然，他是 众生中的超灵，他就在众生的心中帮助众生，指导众生。
When he comes to this world, he comes along with his many different devotees, and he brings also his holy dham, and performs his wonderful pastimes.
他降临这个物质世界的时候，也带来了奉献者圣谛，在物质世界上演他的逍遥。
And these pastimes are all talked about and recorded in the scriptures so that we can all relish remembering the wonders of Lord Krishna.
这些逍遥时光全部就记载在经典当中，经典当中都详细的讨论了 Krishna 的逍遥时光，我们可以记忆他们，我们可以荣耀他们。
Krishna enjoys coming to this world to play with his devotees and perform his different leelas.
Krishna 来这个物质世界，跟他的奉献者们一起玩耍，一起逍遥。
And we also are able to enjoy hearing about all these wonderful pastimes of Lord Krishna.
当我们听到 Krishna 所有这些逍遥时光的时候呢，我们就会乐在其中，津津有味的谈论。
Of course, from Bhagavad Gita, we also know that he comes to kill some demons, and protect his devotees, give pleasure to his devotees.
在《薄伽梵歌》当中呢，就声称了主 Krishna 降临物质世界是为了杀死恶魔，保护奉献者，给奉献者带来快乐。
And then he wants to re-establish Dharma, because Dharma, the religious principles, have been lost. So he comes to re-establish that.
而且由于宗教原则已经遗失了，主 Krishna 降临物质世界的使命就是重建宗教原则。
So these are some of the reasons why Krishna comes to this world.
这就是主 Krishna 来这个世界的原因所在。
So we should hear about we know that Krishna appeared as the eighth child of Vasudeva and Devaki, first of all in Mathura.
首先我们就知道 Krishna 他在 Mathura 以 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的第八个儿子的身份降生了。
They were in the prison, Vasudeva and Devaki were in the prison house of Kamsa, because Kamsa had heard that the eighth child of Vasudeva and Devaki was born to kill him.
那他是降生于主Kamsa的监狱当中，因为Kamsa呢曾经听到一个预言， Vasudeva 和 Devaki 的第八个儿子会杀死他。
So Kamsa's thinking was to keep them in prison, and when they give birth, he will kill the children.
Kamsa 就想出了要把这 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 关在监狱当中，当他们的孩子出生时候就杀死他的孩子。
At the very time of the marriage of Vasudeva and Devaki, there's an omen from the sky saying that the eighth child of this couple is going to kill you, Kamsa.
当在 Devaki 和 Vasudeva 的婚礼上面呢，就从天空当中传来一个预言。这个预言就说，他 Devaki Vasudeva 第八儿子将会杀死 Kamsa。
So when Kamsa heard that, he grabbed Devaki, who was his sister, and he was ready to kill her.
Kamsa 一听说这个预言，马上就抓住他的妹妹 Devaki 的头发，马上就要杀死他的妹妹。
So Vasudeva pleaded with Kamsa to spare his wife.
Vasudeva 就恳求康萨饶了他妻子的命。
They'd just been married that same day, and they were just going to begin their life together, but then Kamsa was going to kill Devaki.
他们在这一天是他们的大喜之日，而在这一天呢，他们正准备开始自己的新生活。Kamsa 呢，就在这一天就要杀死他的妻子。
And so Kamsa, Vasudeva pleaded with Kamsa, and he spoke philosophy. He spoke philosophical about the nature of the soul and the body and how we shouldn't be bewildered by all of these things, that don't be overwhelmed by the affection for the body. But he could not change the mind of Kamsa.
Vasudeva 呢，就试图给 Kamsa 讲哲学道理，告诉他那灵魂的本性以及有关于躯体的本性，他不应该为这些躯体和感到困惑，也不应该对躯体过于爱护这个躯体，所以犯罪。但是他说服不了 Kamsa。
Philosophically, the philosophy Kamsa couldn't accept. He still wanted to kill Devaki.
Kamsa, 他不能接受这些哲学，他仍然一心要杀死 Devaki.
But then Vasudev said, "I will give you our children. When they are born, I will give them to you. You can do whatever you like with them."
这时候 ，Vasudeva 就承诺，当我的儿子降生之后，我会亲手把我的儿子交给你，你愿意怎么处置他就怎么处置他。
And when Kamsa heard this, then he said, "Oh, all right. Then I agree. You, whenever your wife delivers children, you have to bring them to me."
Kamsa 听到 Vasudeva 的这份承诺，他就就心慈手软，就说哦，那好吧，你的儿子什么时候出生之后，你把他交给我就好了。
Very interesting point here to see that philosophy could not convince Kamsa, but the character of Vasudev convinced him. He trusted the character of Vasudev.
非常有趣的一点就是哲学是无法说动康萨的，只是由于 Vasudeva 的品格赢得了康萨的信任，所以康萨才答应不杀死 Devaki。
Kamsa knew Vasudeva to be a very honest and moral person, and he knew that whatever he said, he will keep his word.
Kamsa 知道Vasudeva 是一个诚实守信的人，而是一个非常有道德原则的人，无论他会一诺千金的。
So it happened, Vasudeva and Devaki were put into the prison house, and then when she gave birth one after another, Kamsa came and he killed the children. He killed the first six children of Devaki.
结果呢？就是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 被关在监牢当中，年复一年的，他们一连生了六个儿子。Vasudeva 都把这六个儿子交给 Kamsa。
The seventh child, Lord Balaram appeared in the womb, and Lord Balaram stayed there for some time, and then by Yoga Maya, he transferred from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohini, who was another wife.Of Vasudev.
当第七个儿子 Baladeva 降生的时候， Yoga Maya 就把Balarama 从 Devaki 的子宫转移到 Vasudeva 另一个妻子 Rohini 的子宫当中。
Yeah, Rohini had been sent to the home of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda.For her safety.
Rohini 被转移到 Nanda Maharaj 和 Yashoda 妈妈的家中，以保证她的安全。
So when Balaram was transferred from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohini, they thought that Devaki had had a miscarriage.
当 Balarama 被转移到 Rohini 的子宫当中，他们。
Okay, voice was breaking here. Couldn't hear. So, okay, so then, the eighth child, Lord Krishna, appears first of all in the mind of Vasudev. The birth of Lord Krishna is not by seminal injection, But he appears first of all in the mind of Vasudev, and then he's transferred from the mind of Vasudev to the mind of Devaki, and then into the womb of Devaki.
他们的第八个儿子是这样出生的，首先他出现在Vasudeva的心意当中，他并不是经由男性的精液注入到女性的子宫当中出生的，而是他首先显现在Vasudeva的心意当中，又经由Vasudeva的心意转移到Devaki的心意，从Devaki的心意转移到他，一直到进入到他的子宫中。
So when Krishna took birth in the womb of Devaki, then Devaki became very effulgent because the Supreme Lord was there within her womb. And just by seeing Devaki, they could understand the presence of the Supreme Lord.
当主 Krishna 进入 Devaki 的子宫的时候，她的母亲就显得光辉灿烂，因为至尊主 就在他的子宫当中，他们就也这样呢，人们都可以看出来，他的第八个儿子是一个非凡的人物。So
Lord Krishna appeared from the womb of Devaki in the 8th month of her pregnancy, early, much earlier. Usually it should be 10 months, but after only 8 months, he appeared from the womb of Devaki.
就这样，主奎士呢就在Devaki的子宫当中呢待了八个月，一般来说呢就是怀胎十月，但是主奎士呢只是在他的母亲当中停留了八个月。So
he appeared at midnight in the prison house of Kamsa, and he appeared before Vasudeva and Devaki in a four-armed form, dressed, fully dressed and ornamented.
主 Krishna 是在子夜降临的，他显现在康萨的监狱当中，他是以四臂的形象，并且就是他穿着衣服，然后浑身上下都佩戴着饰物，显现在Vasudeva和Devaki面前。So
this is the form of Vasudev Krishna.
这个形象是 Vasudeva Krishna 形象。
Nanda, when Devaki and Vasudev saw the Lord, they understood that their son had come and that he was the personality of Godhead. They understood their child was actually God himself.
When Devaki and Vasudev saw their son in front of them, they understood that this is God himself.
So they offered prayers to the Lord, and then they requested the Lord to transform himself into the form of a child so that they could make arrangements for his safety.
于是夫妻两个就向主Krishna献上了祈祷，并且恳求他把自己变成一个小婴儿的形象。
So then, of course, Nanda, Vasudev, by the arrangement of Yoga Maya, Vasudev was able to gain, to come out from the prison house and to cross the Yamuna and to go to the home of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda in Gokul.
由于Yoga Maya的安排，Vasudeva就带着主Krishna从监狱当中出来，跨越了Yamuna河，把主Krishna送到了Nanda Maharaj和Yashoda妈妈在Gokula的家中。So
Vasudev brought baby Krishna there, and at the same time which Devaki had delivered a child, at the same time Mother Yashoda had also delivered child.
就婴儿 Krishna 就被带到了狗库了，就是当 Devaki 他生下了这个孩子的同时 亚修的妈妈也同时生下了一个婴儿。
Not just Mother Yashoda had actually delivered two children, one boy and one girl.
事实上，亚修的妈妈是生了一个双胞胎，一个男孩和一个女婴。
So the girl is Yogamaya, and the boy is Shamsundar Krishna.
这个女婴是 Yogamaya。男婴是 Shamsundar Krishna.
Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj had been married a long time, and they had not had a child.
Nanda 大妻呢，很结婚很多年，一直就是膝下无子。
Mother Yashoda was feeling very heartbroken that she was not able to conceive a child. She was not able to deliver even one child for the pleasure of her husband.
亚修的妈妈就感到非常的伤心，她不能怀孕，为她的丈夫生下一儿半女。
So she was lamenting like this for a long time. But then it happened that one Brahmacharini, you know, an ascetic woman who never marries. She came there and she came along with another Brahmachari and they came there and they gave blessings to Mother Yashoda that if you do this vow, if you follow the vow of Dwadasi, then you will get a child.
就是在这个时候，亚修的妈妈就在这里伤心的那时候呢，来了一个女真守生，就是一个女的苦行者，她和另一位男性的真守生就一起来祝福了亚修的妈妈，告诉她说，如果你遵守这个誓言 ，Dwadasi 的誓言，就会生下一个孩子。
So when Mother Yashoda heard about this.Then she appealed to her husband that, oh, we have to do this vow. Let us take this vow, do this Dwadasi Vrat, the vow to follow the Dwadasi. And so Nanda Maharaj agreed. He said, yes, we've never done this. Let's try. Maybe we will be successful.
亚修的妈妈听完之后就开始恳求央求自己的丈夫我们一起来守这个 Dwadasi 的誓言吧。男的大军一听说那好吧我们从来没有守过这个誓言让我们试一下吧看看能不能成功。
So, for one year, Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, they observed this vow.
整整一年的时间，就是南南玛拉和亚修的妈妈守了一年的誓言。
Then, on the night of the first day of the month of Magh means the winter time, January, February. Then, Nanda Maharaj had a dream, and he saw in his dream he saw a baby, who was a blue color.Who was moving in the sky. And he also saw a girl with a golden color.
就在妈的月，也就是冬季一二月份的第一天的夜晚，南达大军当夜做了一个梦，他梦见有一名蓝皮肤的婴儿在天空移动，同时还有另外一名金色皮肤的女孩也在那里。
So these two forms, the boy and the girl, they entered into Nanda Maharaj's heart, and they stayed there blissfully.
这两，就这个男孩和女孩就。 他们就以这个形象呢进入到了南的马哈拉吉的心中，并且非常喜乐的在他的心中住在那里。
Then they came out of the heart of Nanda Maharaj and entered into the womb of Yashoda Mata.
之后，这一男一女两个婴儿从南的大君的心中出来，就进入了亚修的妈妈的子宫当中。
Nanda Maharaj saw all this in a dream.
南的大君呢，就在梦中目睹了这一景象。
So Mother Yashoda, hearing about this pregnancy, she became impregnated, and all the gopas and gopis became very happy, and all the people in Vrindavan were very pleased that, oh, Mother Yashoda is conceived, she's going to have a child.
南大大君的这个对梦境的描述之后，他就怀孕了。就是当这个哭了的居民听说亚师的妈妈怀孕的消息，都感到惊喜万分。
So Nanda Maharaj was so happy that his wife is conceived. He gave a lot of charity. He gave a lot of charity to the Brahmanas and the Vaishnavas.And many demigods, they all came even just to get charity from Nanda Maharaj.
当南达马哈拉什听说自己的妻子怀孕了，立刻就非常慷慨大度，他感到如此的欢喜，他布施了 Vaishnava, Brahmana, 甚至半神人们也纷纷为了得到南达大君的布施也都来了。
Then,When Mother Yashoda was in the eighth month of pregnancy, then an astrologer said, this month the child will take birth.
Yashoda's 妈妈怀孕到第八个月的时候，有一位星象家就来给出了一个预言，这个孩子将在本月诞生。
And he will take his birth.On the eighth day of the dark fortnight of the month of Bhadra.
孩子将于就是暗月的在八着月的暗月的第八天出生。
It's a very auspicious time.So the child will take advantage of that auspicious time to take birth.
这是一个良辰吉日，一个非常吉祥的时刻。孩子会利用这个吉时降生于世。
So the astrologer said, when it came to that day, he said, this is the day the mother Yashoda is going to deliver the child today.So they prepared everything. They prepared the room for her to lay down to deliver the child.
等到了这一天到来的时候呢，星象家就说，就在这一天孩子将出生，所以就为亚瑟的妈妈准备好了产房，让她躺下，让她躺下，准备生下这个婴儿。
Yeah, in Vedic culture, there's a special room. They have the room prepared for the woman to go there, and she can lay down there. And they decorate the room with many nice flowers, a nice smell in the room. Everything was prepared nicely so that Mother Yashoda could be peacefully lay and deliver the child.
按照伟大的传统，会给孕妇准备一个很好的房间，用鲜花装饰，撒上很多香有香味的液体，准备好了一切，让孕妇躺下来，让她安心的生下孩子。
And expert nurses came to take care of the mother and the child.
还有非常精干的。这接生婆就会来照顾这个母亲和她的婴儿们。
And all the demigods and the heavenly planets, they were all happy because they knew the Lord is going to take birth.
天上的半神人们知道至尊主就要降生了，都欢欣鼓舞。
And Indra was showering rain, usually on the Janmashtami night, at the time of the birth of the Lord. It rains just like it did 5,000 years ago. It was heavy rain that night.
Indra, 天地 Indra 也降下雨水。一般呢，在 Janmashtami 那天晚上会有暴雨，倾盆暴雨，就像五千年前主 Krishna 降生当晚发生的情况一模一样。
So everyone, all the demigods, everyone, they were all so happy because they knew the Lord was coming to take his birth.
每个人，所包括半神在内，都为至尊主将要降临感到欢欣鼓舞。
So even Mother Yashoda, she was asleep. Because it's the middle of the night, and so many people were all asleep, and the child took birth while everyone was sleeping.
那因为是在子夜的时分，所以每个人那时候呢正在酣睡。
Even Mother Yashoda was sleeping. She gave birth to her children without any pain.
就连亚修的妈妈当时呢，也是在睡眠当状态当中，她是没有任何痛苦生下自己的孩子。
Birth of Lord Krishna is not like any other child.
主 Krishna 的降生可不像普通孩子的降生。
So Mother Yashoda, she delivered, we said, the one child who was Shamsundar Krishna, a beautiful boy, and she also delivered the girl who is Yogamaya.
Yashoda 妈妈就生下了一名美丽的男婴 Shamsundar Krishna 和一名女婴 Yogamaya.
So Vasudev, he crossed the Yamuna River. He came there with Lord Krishna, his child, Vasudev Krishna, and he exchanged the boy child with the girl child. He only saw Yashoda as a girl. So he took the girl and put the boy, Vasudev Krishna, there with Mother Yashoda, and he took that Yogamaya. But actually what he took was actually not Yogamaya, but Mahamaya.
Vasudeva Krishna 就跨越了雅穆纳河来到沟库了，他就把这名把自己的婴儿与亚修的妈妈的女婴交换了，他当时只看见了女婴，所以他便放下了 Vasudeva Krishna， 带走了，他带走的并不是 Yogamaya， 带走的是 Mahamaya。
Yeah, because Vasudeva he didn't see Krishna, he didn't see that Yashoda has a boy, he just took the girl, and what happened? The boy who he took.He put there with Mother Yashoda, that boy Vasudev Krishna, he entered into the form of Shamsundar Krishna.
Vasudeva 当时是没看见亚修的妈妈生下的男婴，当他把自己带来的这 Vasudeva Krishna 放下之后，这名男婴就进入了 Shamsundar 的形象。
So the son of Nanda and Yashoda, that is Shamsundar Krishna, that is the Swayam Bhagavan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Vasudev Krishna, that is the expansion of Lord Krishna.
Nanda 大 君和亚修达的儿子 Shama Sundar Krishna 是最原初的至尊性格神首 Svayam Bhagavan， 而 Vasudeva Krishna 是 Shama Sundar Krishna 的扩展。
So Vasudeva Krishna, the four-handed form of Krishna, he can enter into the form of Ishamsundar Krishna, and because that is subordinate, it's an expansion. The original form is the Ishamsundar Krishna, two-armed form, and the four-armed form comes from that two-armed form.
Vasudeva Krishna 四臂的 Vasudeva Krishna 能够进入两臂的 Shamasundar Krishna 的形体当中，因为四臂的 Vasudeva Krishna 是两臂的 Shamasundar Krishna 的扩展。
So this is the work of this is done by Yoga Maya, and Vasudeva he could not understand this.He didn't know at all about this. But Mother Yashoda, she also didn't know because she's asleep. Everyone was asleep.
亚修的妈妈对此也都一无所知，因为她当时正处在睡眠当中，而且所有的人也都沉沉的在睡梦乡中。
So the daughter was Yoga Maya, and along with Yoga Maya, Mahamaya is within Yoga Maya.
亚修的妈妈的女儿是 Yoga Maya， 而 Mahamaya 就在 Yoga Maya 的体内。
So Vasudeva took Mahamaya with him back to Mathura.
因此 ，Vasudeva 就抱起了 Mahamaya 回到了 Mathura.
And it was Mahamaya he gave to Kamsa, and Kamsa tried to kill her.But the form rose up in the sky and revealed herself, revealed her divine nature.
Vasudeva 呢就把 Mahamaya 交给了 Kamsa. Kamsa 试图要杀死 Mahamaya 的时候，Mahamaya 就升到了半空当中，就显现出他神圣的形象。
And in this way, people thought.Devaki had given birth to a daughter.
就这样呢，人们就纷纷认为 Devaki 生了个女儿。
So this is the birth of Krishna.
这就是 Krishna 的降生。
But more important, we are also celebrating the day after Janmashtami.We're celebrating, of course, Nanda Maharaj is celebrating because his wife has delivered a beautiful boy, Shamsundar Krishna. So it's Nanda Mahotsav, the day after Janmashtami. Nanda Maharaj's festival gives a feast for all the people. He's very happy. He gives a lot of charity to everyone. So it's a big festival the day after Janmashtami.
南达大君为了庆祝自己的妻子生下一名美丽的男婴，便举行了非常盛大的节日，并且做了大餐来，并且进行了大量的布施。
And we are also celebrating not only Nanda Mahotsav but also Prabhupada's Vyasa Puja.
我们不仅要庆祝Nanda Mahotsava， 也同时庆祝圣帕帕德的 Vyasa Puja。
So it's a very, very special day for all of us. And all the devotees of ISKCON are expected to write a homage, an offering to Srila Prabhupada in appreciation.
每一个奉献者都要向圣帕帕德供奉祷文。
And we will have a big feast and a big festival for Vyasa Puja.
我们将在圣帕帕德Vyasa Puja这一天进行做一个盛大的庆典，而且做盛大的大餐。
And even if you can't do it, you can do it in your mind. Within your mind, you can do it. Even if you can't actually do it in at least in your mind, have a festival.
如果你不能真正的亲临其境，你要在心意当中，就是在心意当中做一个真正的庆典。
Just like Vasudev, he was in prison. He was in the prison house of Kamsa. When his wife delivered the child, he wanted to give charity, but he was in prison. He couldn't do anything, but within his mind, he gave charity.
就像 Vasudeva, 他当时是在 Kamsa 监狱当中，他是不能亲自就是做这个庆祝活动，所以他想布施，他便在他的心意当中，做了大量布施。
So somehow we want to celebrate. If we cannot celebrate physically, then celebrate within the mind.
So we should celebrate this holiday. If we cannot participate physically, at least in our mind, we should celebrate.
Okay. Well, are there any questions?
Krishna，我们有问题。庞基东，是帕布吧？顶拜咕噜，翻译你好。Krishna为什么降临在印度？为什么有的人不相信Krishna呢？
Krishna doesn't take birth in India. He takes birth in the holy dham. The holy dham is a replica of the spiritual world.
Krishna 不是降临印度，他是降生于圣地，圣地是灵性世界的复制品。
Just like you have a Chinese embassy in India, the Chinese embassy is not part of India, it's part of China.
就像我们在印度有驻华驻印度使馆。 这个驻印度的中国大使馆，它并不属于印度领土，它属于中国领土。So
the Lord comes in special places. He doesn't. He just like a farmer. We give an example. The farmer has a lot of land, but he has a special piece of land where he will build his home and where he will live with his family. You know, of all the land, he has a lot of land. But he will have a special area where he will like to build his home and live with his family.
我们打一个比方，正像一名农民，他有大量的田地，但他会挑选出一块特殊的土地来建造自己的家园，和自己的家人一起生活在这块土地上。这块区域是一个特殊的区域。
So Krishna selected that not just India, but this special place called Vrindavan, where he had all the things which he likes very much, he arranged. He had the Yamuna River, he had the Govardhan Hill, he had all the cows and the peacocks and the monkeys, all of these things very special for the pastimes of Krishna.
就 Krishna， 他挑选的不仅仅就是印度，而是特殊的 Vrindavan 之地，在这个地方，并且安排了 Yamuna 河、Golden 山、母牛、 孔雀、猴子等等这些特殊的那个特殊的生物，在那里上演他自己的逍遥。
You cannot find all of these things in America or Russia or China, but we find it there in Mathura, in Vrindavan.
不能在美国、俄国、中国发现这一景象，你只能在 Mathura, Vrindavan 找到这一景象。
So it does not just come in India. There was no India 5,000 years ago.These names and these borders, these are all modern creations.
5,000 years 前并不存在印度，这个国度这一说。当时这现代的边疆，现在的国家之间的边界是现代的创造。
And Krishna appears not only on this planet, he appears in many other planets also for his different pastimes.
Krishna 不仅仅是降生于这个星球，他还会降生于其他的星球来上演他自己的逍遥。
So he has...His favorite places, we have to understand. Some places he likes very much because the people are very pious and very religious, and they take care of the cows. So these things are very important to Krishna.
主 Krishna 他有自己最喜欢的地方。在这个地方人们都非常虔诚，有宗教心，照料母牛，而这一切是至关重要的。
But Krishna is not an Indian.
Krishna 不是一个印度人。
He is the Supreme Lord. It's all his creation.
他是至尊主，这一切全都是他的创造。
那个问题，第二部分是什么
？Why don't somebody believe in Krishna?
Why do people not believe in Krishna?
Yes.
Well, everyone has free will. Krishna does not force people that you have to believe me. Krishna gives us free will.
每个生物都有自由意志，主 Krishna 他不会强迫人，你必须得信我。人人都有他们自由意志。
In the spiritual world, excuse me. In the spiritual world, everyone believes in Krishna. Everyone has faith in Krishna. Hare Krishna.
在灵性的世界，每一个生物都相信 Krishna。
This is the material world. We're in the bad place. People are not very pious. We're not very good people. But you go to Vrindavan. If you go to Vrindavan, everybody believes in Krishna. It's only these other places outside Vrindavan.People don't believe in Krishna.
我们现在是身处物质世界，是一个物质世界，它是不好的人住的地方，而虔诚的人就是在稳达稳的地方的人，所有的人都相信 Krishna， 那里的人就非常虔诚，而在稳达稳外面的人。其他地方的人呢，我有的人不相信 Krishna。
Krishna said, I am never manifest to the foolish and the unintelligent. So this is the problem. People are very foolish and unintelligent. So they cannot understand Krishna.
Krishna 说，我从来不向愚昧 没有智慧的人展示我自己，所以问题就在于那些愚昧的没有智慧的人，他们不相信 Krishna。
Even though we can see the signs of God everywhere, the creation of God everywhere, but still with many people are atheists. We think there's no God.
虽然我们不再都可以见到神的科学，见证神的创造，仍然有那些无神论者不相信神。
Now we're in this very dark age, Kali Yuga. People are very irreligious, impious, and that's why we have so many things like disease everywhere.
我们现在这个年代是黑暗的年代，卡里年代，到处都是没有缺乏宗教心的不虔诚的人士，所以我们看到现在有这种疾病。
You go to higher planets, you see there's no disease there.
你去高等的星宿，就能看到在高等的星宿上没有疾病。
People are more pious. They're more God conscious.
那里的人，他们有更强烈的，有更多的虔诚心，他们有更高的神的知觉。
还有问题吗？
有的，今天问题还不少。下一个问题，拉扎日帕布，感谢马哈拉扎，感谢翻译主持。Krishna 显现的主要原因是满足他的纯粹奉献者渴望见到他的愿望。问题是 ，Krishna 的纯粹奉献者已经在万事万物中见到 Krishna 了。他们蔑视解脱，有时甚至还时时看到 Krishna 的逍遥时光，为什么还渴望见到 Krishna 呢？
Well, actually, pure devotees don't just simply desire to see Krishna, but they desire to serve Krishna.
实际上，纯粹的奉献者不是渴望见到 Krishna。纯粹的奉献者欲求服务 Krishna。
That's more pleasure. There's more pleasure in serving Krishna than in simply seeing Krishna.
服务 Krishna 去获得的快乐要大于仅仅见到 Krishna。
Srimati Radharani gets pleasure in serving Krishna, not just simply in seeing Krishna.
Srimati Radharani, 她是透过服务 Krishna 而感到心满意足，而不是通过见到 Krishna 感到心满意足。
So the pure devotees, like the gopis of Vrindavan, their mood in serving Krishna is service in separation.
文大文的纯粹奉献者，那些牧牛姑娘，他们的服务是处在分离当中的服务。
And that mood of service attracts Krishna. Krishna is only attracted by devotional service. It's devotional service which controls Krishna.
而这种分离当中的服务吸引了 Krishna。纯粹的奉献服务能够吸引 Krishna， 能够控制 Krishna。
Krishna is unconquerable, but he becomes conquered by the pure love of his devotees.
Krishna 是不可的，但是被纯奉献者的爱所征服。
还有问题？
是的，下一个问题，潘查塔特瓦帕布，顶拜古鲁马哈拉扎，感 现在 Devaki 和 Vasudeva 面前，然后变成四臂小男孩，在 Devaki 祈祷后变成两臂形体。从这个逍遥时光，明显是 Vishnu 变成 Krishna， 是 Krishna 的来源。薄伽梵歌里又说 Krishna 是所有化身的源头，是 Vishnu 的源头，如何理解呢？
Translate。
Lord Vishnu appeared in front of Devaki and Vasudeva in the prison house of Kamsa, and then he transformed into a four-armed little boy. After the praying of Devaki, he then transformed into two-armed body. From this Leela, it's the obvious, it is Lord Vishnu that has changed, transformed into Krishna. Lord Vishnu is the source of Lord Krishna. Yet in Bhagavad Gita, it is said Krishna is the source of all incarnation, is the source of Lord Vishnu. How can we understand these contents?
Well, I tried to explain this morning that the child who is born to Vasudev and Devaki is Vasudev Krishna. Vasudev Krishna means like Vishnu. Vasudev Krishna, the four-armed form. It's subordinate to the form of Shamsundar Krishna, who was the child of Nanda and Yashoda. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Swayam Bhagavan, was born to Yashoda and Nanda, not to Vasudev and Devaki.
我在今天早上的这堂课当中一直在解释，Vasudeva Krishna 是 Vasudeva 的儿子，他是 Vasudeva Krishna 降生在这个监狱当中，而 Vasudeva Krishna 是 Vishnu， 是四臂的 Vishnu， 而这个 Vasudeva Krishna 是从属于 Shyamasundara Krishna。而 Shyamasundara Krishna 才是 Nanda 大君和亚修的妈妈所生下的儿子，是至尊性格神手 Swayam Bhagavan。这个是亚修的妈妈和 Nanda 大君的儿子。
The position.
Nanda 大。
Go ahead, Jisha.
不是 Vasudeva 和 Devaki 所生下的这个儿子，是原初的性格神手。
So, the position of Nanda and Yashoda is above the position of Vasudev and Devaki.
Nanda 和亚修的地位是又超越了高于 Devaki 和 Vasudeva.
Vasudev and Devaki, they performed austerities previously to get the Lord as their child for three births.
Vasudeva 和 Devaki 从事了长期的苦行，以求得到主至尊主做三世成为他们的儿子。
And so when the Lord came the third time in the prison house of Kamsa, that was the third birth, we see that Vasudeva and Devaki offered prayers to the Lord.
当主降生于监狱当中，就是曾在 Devaki 和 Vasudeva 面前成为他们的儿子的时候，我们看到Devaki 和 Vasudeva 开始向主供奉祷文。
This offering of prayers indicates their mood of awe and veneration, giving great respect to the Lord.
他们是以敬畏的心态向主呈现了敬意。
But Nanda and Yashoda, they don't offer prayers to Krishna because they think of Krishna as their child.
Nanda 和 Yashoda 并没有向Krishna 供奉祈祷，他们只是把 Krishna 当成他们的孩子。
They're enjoying the mood of parental affection with Lord Krishna. And this is more pleasing to Krishna than the offering of prayers.
他们在享受的是作为父母在给 Krishna 以父爱和母亲的爱来对待主 Krishna， 而这一点是更能取悦主 Krishna 的。 比起供奉祷文，主Krishna是更欣赏前者。Yeah,
Krishna enjoys this natural loving relationship with his devotees without all the awe and reverence.
主Krishna喜欢这种自然而关系，而不是带着敬畏之情的这种关系。
We see also when it comes to killing the demons, who kills the demons? It's not Shamsundar Krishna, that is the Vasudev form, Vasudev Krishna, who goes and kills the demons. Shamsundar Krishna is enjoying the Rasa Leela, dancing with the gopis, he's with the pastimes with the devotees. But the killing of the demons is done by the Vasudev Krishna form.
我们看看是谁杀死了恶魔呢？不是Shamsundar Krishna杀死了恶魔，而是Vasudeva Krishna的形象去杀掉了恶魔，而Shamsundar Krishna只是在享受Rasa之舞，享受。 跟奉献者在一起的逍遥时光。
Vasudev and Devaki, they didn't get to enjoy Krishna's childhood pastimes. That's only Nanda and Yashoda. They're always Krishna's mother and father.
Vasudev 和 Devaki 并没有享受了主 Krishna 的孩提时代的逍遥时光，而Nanda和 Yashoda 才享受到了主 Krishna 的孩提的逍遥时光。他们是主 Krishna 永恒的父母。Vasudev
and Devaki, they could give birth to Krishna. That was it. Then he has to go. They take him to Gokul. They don't get to see any of the childhood pastimes.
Vasudeva and Devaki 只是生下了主 Krishna 而已。之后呢，主 Krishna 就走了，去了狗窟了。他们 Vasudeva and Devaki 没能目睹主 Krishna 孩提的逍遥。It's
the childhood pastimes which are the most enjoyable. If we ask any parent, you know, those of you who have children, you have a child, you when they're young, when they're small, you have so much pleasure, so much enjoyment with them. But once they grow up a bit, it's not the same.
喜悦的，你可以去问一下任何的父母亲，当他们孩子还小的时候呢，这孩子给他们带来的快乐，是他们特别能乐在其中的快乐。当孩子长大之后就不一样了。Yeah,
you know, once the child grows up a bit, he's going to argue with the mother and father, and they're going to fight with each other. So many things, very different relationship.
孩子一旦长大一点点，就开始跟父母辩论、争论，孩子们彼此之间呢也互相在那里打架，就是完全不一样。还有问题吗？是的，我们还有不少问题呢。
下一个问题是一位新朋友 ，Kite Director， 请问 Krishna 在午夜显现有什么意义吗？如果凌晨五点显现，我们是不是必须也届时到五点呢？
So what's the meaning for Lord Krishna to appear in the midnight? If Lord Krishna appear at five o'clock in the morning, so we have to fast until 5 o'clock.
Well, you have to understand the planets are in different positions, different times of the day. So there's the particular auspicious time for Krishna to take his birth. The most auspicious time was at the stroke of midnight.
您得理解，就是这个星球，它在不同的位置上，就是在不同的时间，它是有不同的意义的。在子夜的时候，就是半夜十二点当中，当时那个时辰是最吉祥的时刻。
If Krishna had appeared at 5 o'clock in the morning, then we can fast until midday and break fast at midday.
如果Krishna 显现在凌晨五点钟，我们也可以届时到半夜十二点，然后在半夜十二点打破届时。
But Krishna appeared at midnight, so we accept that because it was midnight, which was the auspicious time. If you can do astrological calculations to look at the positions of the different planets at the exact time when Krishna took his birth, and you will see how it was very, very, very special positions of all the planets.
但是主 Krishna 他是在半夜十二点当中，十二点的时候降生的。你可以去研究一下当时那个时候的所有星象图，你就会发现那个半夜十二点钟是最为吉祥的一个时刻。
Not just only the place, not just only the time is important, but the actual place. And remember, Krishna, he took his birth in Vrindavan. So in Vrindavan, at that particular time was the most auspicious, very special time for the Lord to appear.
不仅仅是这个时间，还有地点。你要记住，主 Krishna 是在温达达文降生。达文这个特殊的时间啊，就是当时最吉祥的一个时刻。
OK， 还有问？
好的，下一个问题。Subhadra 是 Durga 女神吗？还是 Yoga Maya 还是 Mahamaya？ 又有说都不是，只是 Krishna 的妹妹，是个体灵魂。还有的说是幸运女神的扩展，哪个对？
Okay, Subhadra, that's a complex subject. There are different Subhadras mentioned.
有关于 Subhadra， 这是一个复杂的问题。提到了有不同的 Subhadra。
There's one Subhadra who comes, who gets married to Arjuna.
有一位 Subhadra 嫁给了 Arjuna。
Right. You know, it's a whole subject matter. Maybe I'll give another class sometime. We'll have another class about Subhadra.I don't want to get into it right now. It's very complex and I'm not so familiar with it. I have to read up all the material on it, and then I'll explain it another time when I'm more familiar with all the material, because there's a lot of stuff written about it and I have to look over it and understand it, and then I'll try to explain it.
这个问题非常复杂，这个题旨是一个复杂的题旨，也许我应该再讲一堂课。因为我现在还不熟悉，我需要查找资料来熟悉所有这些材料。然后当我把这些所有的这个资料提 体质都熟悉之后，我会单讲一堂课。
好的，那我们下一个问题。Kelly Lalita Madaji， 顶拜 Guru Day， 请问 Guru， 讲讲 Yoga Maya 和 Maha Maya 的区别，他们分别代表什么品质
？OK， so Yoga Maya means the Lord's spiritual. The Yoga Maya is arranges the different.Oversees the different energies of the Lord, the different potencies of the Lord. Works. Yoga Maya works to cover up Krishna so that the devotee can enjoy dealing with him as their son, just like Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. They don't think of Krishna as being God, they only think of Krishna as their son.So that's by yoga, the influence of Yoga Maya.
Yoga Maya 主要是安排监督主的能量、主的能力。Yoga Maya 覆盖了主 Krishna， 好让奉献者可以享受跟 Krishna 之间的交往。主 Krishna， 比如说男的，亚瑟的妈妈就把主 Krishna 当作自己的儿子。他们并不把他当作是神，而是当作自己的儿子。这是 Yoga Maya 的影响。
And Mahamaya is a part of Yoga Maya. See, just like electricity can be used in different ways. Electricity can be used to heat. Electricity can be used to cool. It's all done by electricity. So Yoga Maya is like the electricity, which has different effects.So one effect is to cover up Krishna as the child, and the other effect is to cover up Krishna to reveal him like an ordinary person.
Mahamaya 是 Yoga Maya 的一部分，就像电能，电可以制热，也可以制冷。所以 Yoga Maya 它的效力就是。他把 Krishna 给覆盖起来了，就显在他的奉献者面前显得就像个儿子。那他另外一个效果呢，就是同时把 Krishna 遮盖起来，让有的人认为他只是个普通人而已。
Like Kamsa, he thinks of Krishna under the influence of Yoga Maya, and he wants to kill Krishna.
像 Kamsa。在 Yoga Maya 的力量之下，他想杀死 Krishna。
So the demons they see Krishna by Yoga Maya. They're trying to kill Krishna.
恶魔。
Mahamaya, not Yoga Maya, Mahamaya.
恶魔就是由于 Mahamaya 的作用，在 Maha。
So Mahamaya is for the non-devotees and Yoga Maya is for the devotees.
Hare Krishna. Guru Mani Madaji, 您那儿有点断续，信号不是特别好了，您调整一下位置。
OK.Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare
Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.或者是看守所不能吃到素食怎么办？谢谢。
Well, yeah, if people are put into jail and they cannot be vegetarian. What can they do? What can they do? You have to decide what you want to do. Everybody's an individual. You have to decide. Do what you want.
您得自己。来决定， 都是个体的，您可以做按照您想要做的去做。
Some people have very strong determination. They may not eat. They will just simply eat the rice. They won't eat any of the meat.
有的人决心很强烈，他们会不吃，他们只吃大米饭，不吃肉。
It's an individual question. Everyone has, you have to decide for yourself in terms of the situation what you're going to do.
这是按个体的情况，您得自己做决定，根据情况自己做决定。
Somehow you may be able to take some vegetables, separate some vegetables from the meat.You may have to eat something like that. You may have to tolerate these different conditions.
您可以把挑出肉菜里的蔬菜来，单独吃蔬菜，你得容忍这种情况。
下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题 ，Hare Krishna， 是帕布还是马德吉本的顶拜咕噜。Jamasthami 这天届时到午夜，如果是年纪大的老人或者身体不好的奉献者无法届时到午夜，在这天应该怎么才能取悦主呢？
Well, you can please Krishna simply by remembering Krishna and chanting his holy name. Older people especially over 80, they're not expected to fast.
可以通过记忆 Krishna, 意念 Krishna,唱诵圣名来祈愿 Krishna， 80岁以上的老人就不用戒食。
And if you have health problems, you have some health difficulties, and it doesn't matter what your age is, you have to do what's necessary to keep your health. Take care of your health.
如果有健康问题，那不论年龄大小，就要采取必要的行动来照料自己的健康。
And just try to do more chanting and hearing. That's very important. More important than fasting.
做更多的念诵，更多的聆听，这个更重要，比戒食重要。
下一个问题。
好的，下一个问题，顶拜圣人，聆听超人知识。顶拜咕噜，感恩翻译。请问，进入灵性世界的人能够记住他在物质世界的遭遇吗？如果不记得，会不会又瞎闯入物质世界重新轮回呢？
If we go to the spiritual world, will we remember what happened in the material world? If we don't remember what happened, what?
Yes, if we go to the spiritual world, can we remember what happened in the material world? If we cannot, is it we will again enter into material world?
No, not like that at all. If we go to the spiritual world, we'll become so absorbed in service to Krishna in the spiritual world.We won't ever think of going back to the material world.
不是这样的。当我们回到灵性世界的时候，我们会这么一心一意的，专心于在灵性世界的服务，我们就根本就不想，回到物质世界这回事儿，去物质世界这回事儿。
This material world is just like the dream, the bad dream.
好像一场梦，好像一场噩梦。
When we go back to the spiritual world, we don't need to remember anything about this place.
当我们回到灵性世界之后，不需要回忆起这个地方。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，展望的 Priya 马德吉，顶拜马哈拉扎，感恩您。 甜美的讲述 Krishna 显现的逍遥时光。听说节日期间会有特殊的仁慈，能清除内心中平时无法得到净化的某些非常顽固的不吉安达尔塔，是这样吗？我们应该以怎样恰当的心态庆祝 Janmashtami 才能得到这一具有特殊净化力的仁慈呢？一整天只是待在家里念诵和聆听，不做别的服务，这种庆祝方式可以吗？
Yes, definitely. If you're at home and you're hearing and chanting, then that's very good, very pleasing to Krishna. You can spend the day to hear and chant about Krishna. Prabhupada had all the devotees one time in New Vrindavan. He had them all just sit and read Krishna book together. Oh no. Well, that was New Vrindavan one time. Another time in Japan, Prabhupada was in Japan, and they just simply had the Krishna book and they sat and read it the whole day.
肯定是可以的，就坐在家里头聆听唱诵，这是取悦 Krishna 的，一整天都聆听和唱诵。圣帕帕德呢，有一次在新文达文，他就让奉献者坐在那里读一整天，都读 Krishna 快乐的泉源这本书。还有另外一次就是在日本，就是也是坐的奉献者坐了一整天，就在那里读 Krishna 快乐泉源这本书。
Yeah, read about Krishna's birth and the prayers offered by the demigods, and then Krishna's childhood pastimes.
朗读 Krishna 的降生，半神人向 Krishna 的祈祷，以及 Krishna 的孩提逍遥。
Try to chant more rounds.
念诵更多的圈数。
Like that. Krishna knows how much we're trying to please him. It's not what we do, it's not what we give to Krishna, it's what we don't give to Krishna.
努力的去取悦 Krishna, Krishna 会知道的。并不是说我们给 Krishna 什么，关键不是我们给了 Krishna 什么，关键在于我们还有什么没有给 Krishna。
So we make some effort to please Krishna. Krishna is very pleased.
我们做一些努力来取悦 Krishna 的努力， Krishna 就会对我们的这个努力感到满意。
下一个问题。
Good day. Jamuna Priyama, Jamuna Priyama 的吉他上面的问题，他说那个 Janmashtami 是不是有特殊的仁慈，能够清除平时很难去除的 anatta 呢？
清除 anatta, get rid of anattas.
Are there any special mercy in this festival that we can get the special mercy to relieve those very strong anatta that in the ordinary time cannot be removed? Is that
Well, that was more on Balaram Purnima. Balaram Purnima, I spoke about that on Balaram Purnima, the Lord Balaram is the one to remove the anartas because he's the spiritual master, the original spiritual master.
应该是在 Balaram Purnima 这个节日，在这个节日上去除 anarta, 因为
So Balarama is the original teacher. Balarama, he's very powerful to remove the anartas. Lord Krishna's pastimes are more for the pleasure of his pure devotees.
Balarama, he has a very strong power to remove anarta. And Krishna's appearance this day,显现呢，主要是为了取悦纯粹奉献者。
But any day in which you do more hearing and chanting will help you to get rid of your anartas.
任何一天，倘若你做更多的聆听、唱诵，都可以去除 anarta。
Every day is a festival for devotees. not only Janmashtami's festival, every day we're hearing and chanting. So every day we can get rid of anattas.
对奉献者来说，天天都可以过节，不仅仅是Janmashtami，每一天都可以通过聆听、唱诵去除anatta。
Okay. Janmashtami being a festival, so it encourages people who don't do so much hearing and chanting, it encourages them to do hearing and chanting more.
Janmashtami 作为一个大节日, 它可以鼓励那些平常没有做很多聆听唱诵的人, 在这一天从事更多的聆听唱诵。
But devotees, somebody's devotee, every day they're hearing and chanting. So Janmashtami is just another festival for them.
Shall
I go into?
好的，我们下一个问题，太阳花马达吉，顶拜咕噜，请问咕噜，心意总是起起伏伏，如何克服心意的懒惰，一直保持积极的服务心态呢？
How to control the mind?
How to overcome the laziness of the mind? Because the mind is very fickle, and how can we keep the mind in an active mood of service?
Well, you have to be active, and you have to want to do active service. If you're active in service, then you'll conquer the mind.
您必须得想要积极地去从事服务，这样就可以征服心意。
You have to get nice association, you have to be willing to accept instruction from others and to work under the direction of other people who are enthusiastic and who are controlling their mind.
您要有好的联谊，并且愿意接受那别的奉献者的训示去工作，就是您要在那些热情有热情的奉献者，并且从事积极服务的奉献者那里。
We have to train the mind. Constant training means you neglect the mind. Whenever the mind is directing us away from Krishna, then you have to ignore it.
就是只偏离了 Krishna 的时候，每当这时候就忽视心意。
So you have to know when the mind is being your friend and when it's being an enemy. And you have to know when to take care of the mind, when to neglect it, and when to listen to the mind.
您要区分什么时候心意是您的朋友，在哪一时刻心意又变成了您的敌人。您要知道。 该在何时照顾您的心意，何时又该忽视着心意，而在何时又何时聆听心意。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题，凯特瑞克的这位新朋友问，就是明天是一个非常好的节日，犹豫是不是明天需要上班还是请假，请问咕噜有什么建议？
That is up to you to decide. If you're able to take the day off, if you don't need to go to work, then you can do it, okay. But if you're going to take the day off, then you should be fully engaged in hearing and chanting and doing service for Krishna. Don't just take the day off and do nothing.
这取决于您。如果您能请下假来不上班，那这样做是可以的。但是。 如果您那个请了假，那看您怎么利用这一天。 这一天呢，您可以聆听唱诵，从事服务，而不应该是是的。
And you don't want to lose your job. If it's not easy to get jobs these days, so if you have a job, you want to be careful that you don't do anything to jeopardize it.
而且您也不应该就是您也不应该失业，因为现在这个时候，有一份工作挺不容易的，所以您应该小心您的行为，不要就是让您的职业这份工作的变成就是妨碍您，完了您就是失业了，这就不好了，不要妨害您的工作。
下一个问题。
下一个问题，Dropati Mataji， 亲爱的 Guruji， 为了照顾家人，隔三差五的，就是隔一段时间我们就会有一个小的聚会，虽然我跟 Charumani Chatura Mataji 用专用的厨具为主做素食供奉，但是家里的非奉献者喜欢 吃我们做的素食，也会帮忙做厨房服务，就包包子呀、包饺子呀之类的。我们也跟他们一起会，嗑瓜子聊天。但我发现精神状态和念诵的时候会很累，念的也很慢。我的问题是，我们是不是也要特别的小心与非奉献者家人的精微的影响？如何保护自己呢？是不是控制舌头才能更好的控制心意？从这个角度来说，是不是服务保护服务呢？
Well, yeah. Controlling the tongue, certainly very helpful. If you control the tongue, but you have to, your mind is going to be a very big factor. If you don't control your mind, you won't be able to control your tongue. The control of the tongue comes from the mind.
控制舌头肯定是很有帮助的，但是控制心意是一个主要因素，如果控制了心意，就能控制住舌头。
So association with people who are not devotees, you have to give them association. You have to keep them Krishna conscious. They're not devotees, so you have to be careful to keep yourself Krishna conscious by speaking about Krishna, or when you're working, bowing, when you fold the jausa, bow jausa, at that time you should put some nice music, kirtan music, or listen to the play a recording, some lecture, and this way keep the atmosphere Krishna conscious.
您跟非奉献者家人相处的时候要给予他们 Krishna 知觉，也要小心保护好自己的 Krishna 知觉，要讲述 Krishna。当你包饺子的时候呢，同时放一些好听的 kirtan， 或者是讲课录音，营造 Krishna 知觉的氛围。
Don't let them just talk nonsense.
不要就让他们在那里胡说八道。
They shouldn't talk if they're going to bow, if they're doing things in the kitchen for the service of Krishna. They shouldn't be talking.
他们不应该讲。如果他们在厨房为 Krishna 服务的时候，应该是闭上嘴不说话。
OK， 还有吗？还有
还有，是的，我们还有一个问题。吴秀红满的锦，顶拜咕噜莲花族，顶拜奉献者。厨房总是有小虫子，在。杀虫之前，消毒之前，跟他们打招呼，请他们搬走，给他们时间，然后我再消毒杀菌，可以吗？
嗯，what does she want to do? 她想做什么？
She would say something to this.
Tell them to go out. Yeah. But
give them time to move away from the kitchen.
Oh.
And then
Then kill them.
And then, 消毒杀菌 yes, maybe. But put some
chemicals.
Yes.
Okay. So, when Tada went to Shishima?
Is that okay for her to do like this?
Yeah, it's up to you. And you have to be careful. Keep your kitchen clean. If insects are coming, if you clean it all the time, they won't come. Keep it very clean. Don't keep any food laying around. Keep everything away. Keep in containers, sealed containers, so that they don't get anything to eat. And then they won't keep coming.
这取决于您，您要保持这个清洁。如果您小心，很小心的，保持清洁的话，这虫子就不来了。就不要把食物随手就乱放，要放好，放在冰箱里，密封好，这样虫就不招虫子了。
I know because you're all living in apartments, so the people next door and the people upstairs, the people below, they may have so many insects there, and they may come from their places.
我知道是你们住在公寓楼，有邻居家或者是楼上楼下的邻居，从他们家就会窜过来一些小虫子。
Anyway, you don't want to be, we have to be careful about killing insects because there is a hell where people go who kill insects.
我们要小心，对于杀虫子这件事要小心。有一个地狱，就是那些杀虫、昆虫的人去的地方。
But you don't want to allow the insects to come everywhere in your home. You have to keep them out.
但是您不会允许虫子在您家到处乱爬，您肯定是要把它们请出去。
But if they know they're not going to get anything to eat there, they won't keep coming.
关键是如果这些虫子知道在您家找不到任何食物可吃的话，那这些虫子就不会不请自来了。
So take some patience.
要耐心。
Okay. 今天就到这儿吗？还有。
是的，是的。
Yeah?
没有问题了。
好 ，Okay. So wish you all have a very happy Janmashtami and Vyasa Puja.
祝你们有一个快乐的 Janmashtami 庆祝日，还有快乐的Vyasa Puja 日。
We hope Lord Krishna and Srila Prabhupada will bestow his blessings on all of you.
我们希望主 Krishna、Srila Prabhupada 把他们的祝福赐予你们。
Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.